Hi, welcome to the Module 3, Lesson 2 of your Statistics and Probability course. In today's video, we will be talking about the area under the normal curve. For this lesson, you will be able to identify regions under the normal curve corresponding to different standard normal values and convert a normal random variable to a standard normal variable and vice versa. Let's begin our discussion. So we begin our discussion again by asking this question, what is a standard normal distribution? Any set of normally distributed data can be converted to its standardized form, and the desired probabilities can then be determined from a table of the normal distribution. So we have learned in the previous video that there are infinitely many normal distributions. Okay? And we can convert, this normal distribution in its standardized form so that we will be able to know the probabilities using a table. Okay? So what is the implication of this? Since there are many, infinitely many normal distribution, okay, and converting it in standardized form, we can compare, okay? We can compare each of the normal distribution because of the standardization. Okay, nakakapag-standardize tayo. Meaning to say, pare-pareho yung units na ginagamit natin, so we can compare them. Okay? Say for example, we would like to compare your performance in statistics and probability course and your performance in physical science, say for example, in practical research 1, say for example, for your hope 2, say for example, and so on and so forth. Okay? We are able to do that by standardizing the normal distributions or the normal or the raw scores you have in those mentioned subjects. Okay? So how do we define a standard normal distribution? A standard normal distribution is a normal distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation equals 1. So take note, it said here that number 1, a standard normal distribution is a normal distribution. Meaning to say that the standard normal distribution is a subset of a normal distribution. Or in layman term, anak ng normal distribution, si standard normal distribution. Number 2, the standard normal distribution is very particular. Okay, in that the mean is 0 and standard deviation, which is equal to 1. Tinan nyo ha, very unique yan. Doon sa normal distribution natin, we did not mention the value of the mean. Notice, oh, mean, mu lang yan, saka standard deviation, sigma. Okay? But for the standard normal distribution, we are so particular that the mean is only 0 and the standard deviation is equal to 1. So by that, we are able to compare each normal distribution, okay, by standardizing them because there is only one mean and there is only one standard deviation. Although there are infinitely many normal distributions, because the mean and the standard deviation could vary, there is only one standard normal distribution as it has only one value for the mean and one value for the standard deviation. A random variable with the standard normal distribution is usually denoted by the letter Z. Ibang countries, they pronounce it as Z. Okay? So it's okay. Then small letter or capital letter, it will be fine. The horizontal scale of the graph of the normal standard normal distribution corresponds to Z-scores. Okay? Z-scores. Anong Z-scores? These are the number of standard deviations, an element or our value is from the mean. So, So, anong sinasabi ng definition natin? The z-score is the number of standard deviation. The number of standard deviations from the mean. Okay? And, ito, tingnan nyo ito. Notice that in this given figure, yung first row, these are the normal scores or the raw scores. Okay? And notice that we don't have any values for it because it can vary, as I said a while ago. But when we convert these normal scores to standard scores or standard normal scores or z-scores, pare-pareho lang yan ha, notice that ito lang yung value niya. Okay? Ito lang. So we have 0, which is the mean. Okay? And the standard deviation is 1. Notice that the distance for each standard deviation is 1. Okay? Yun ang ibig sabihin niyan. So, to the right of the mean, which is 0, meaning that that it has a greater value. And to the left of the mean, lesser value. Okay? Compared to the mean, which is the reference point. Now, how do we convert a normal score to a z-score? If x is a normal random variable with mean mu and standard deviation sigma, then z is equal to x, okay, or the normal score minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. It is a standard normal random variable. Excuse me. Again, ha, small letter tong dalawang to or capital letter, okay lang. Now, let's have an example. Find the z-score given that x is equal to 45, and mu is equal to 39 or the mean and standard deviation is 4. Okay? Let's have an example. So for letter A, the mean is 45, x is 45, standard deviation, the normal score is 45, the mean is 39, and the standard deviation is 4. Okay, so let's find the z. What's unknown is z. So the formula, z is x minus the mean all over the standard deviation. Just plug in the given values. We have 45 minus 39 all over 4 is 45 minus 39. We have what? 45 minus 39. Minus 39 is 6 divided by 4. Is 1.5 or 1.3. Okay? Next, for letter B, let's write down the given first. So, para madali na lang matandaan at i-enter na lang. Z is unknown. We have 108, 116, 6.85. Okay, so let's look for the value of z. Just plug in using this formula. We have 108 minus 116 divided by 6.85 is negative, this one is negative 8 over 6.85. Divide natin yan. 8 divided by 6.85 negative 8 is 1.17. Round off with the two decimal places. 1.17. Okay? So I would like to emphasize that whenever you find the z-score, it's rounded off to the nearest two decimal places. Okay? Hundredths place. Mamaya malalaman nyo kung bakit. Okay? Now, tingnan nyo. I want you to notice on the value of the z-score for each of the example. For the first example, the z-score is positive, but the z-score of the second example is negative. Okay, so kailan pa nagiging positive, kailan nagiging negative? Take note, tignan nyo to. The mean here is, okay, the mean of this given example is less than the normal score. So, positive ang z-score. While for the second example, the mean is greater than the normal score. So, therefore, negative ang z-score. Okay? Nasa left siya, ibig sabihin. Nasa right naman yung isa. Nakaintindihan po ba? Okay. Now, the standard normal distribution table shows the cumulative area associated with a particular z-score. And the rows show the whole number and the tenths place of the z-score, while the columns show the hundredths place. And the cumulative area, okay, of 10 from negative infinity to the z-score appears in the cell of the table. For us to have a better idea of what this looks like, okay, so I'm going to show to you what is a standard normal distribution table. Okay, so this one is a standard distribution table, normal distribution table, or we call it the z-table. Okay, the z-table. We are so, pag meron na kayo nito, don't lose it because gagamitin nyo yun hanggang matapos yung course ninyo. Statistics probability. Take note that the area to the left, we are talking at the area to the left. Okay, sabi doon, the rows, okay, ito yung mga rows daw, naglalagay siya ng, ano sabi doon, the whole number and the tens place. Whole number. Pero yan, integer nilagay ko sa inyo. Kasi, left and right now. Ayan, no? Positive, may negative z-scores. Okay? And sabi dyan, the columns daw, the hundredths place. Okay? While itong mga intersection niya, these are the cumulative area, or this is what we call the probability. The next topic ninyo. Or the percentages, pare-pareho lang yan. Or the percentile, depende sa pagkakagamit niya. Okay? So, dapat kahit ano doon ang sabihin ni Sir Grida sa inyo, alam nyo pa rin. Now, so let's use the Z table to find the area that corresponds to a Z score to the left of 1.45. Okay. What is the area? So number letter A, the area that corresponds to the z-score, which is equal to 1.45. Okay? But take note, I can write this as since left, ang pinag-uusapan natin, ha? So, I can just write equal sign as less than. Kasi ang pinag-uusapan natin is left. The method is always left naman. So, don't be confused. Pag naglagay ako ng equals dyan, okay lang. Pag less than, okay lang din. Pero mamaya, pag greater than, saka ibang notation na yun, ibang usapan na yun. Palagi natin ito ng sa ilalim. Less than or equal to. Pareho lang yan. Ibig sabihin yan. Iisa lang. Okay? Is, let's look at the table, 1.45. The table is positive. Dito siya. 1.45. So, tingin tayo sa 1.4. So, 1.4. Okay, 1.45. Nandito siya. Okay, the intersection. So, 0.9265. So, the area that corresponds to a z-score of 1.45 is 92.65. Okay, double-check ko nga. Oh, 92.65. Or, in percentage, this is 92.65%. Okay? For letter B, the area that corresponds to Z, which is negative 0.54, is negative na. May dalawa na, may negative, may positive, diba? So, negative 0.54, o dito tayo titingin. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0.2946. 0.2946. Okay? That's it. Now, so let's talk about the properties of the standard normal distribution. Since the standard normal distribution is a normal distribution, with certain characteristics, it has some characteristics too, which were as follows. Okay? Number one, the commutative area is close to zero for scores close to negative 2. It's supposed to be negative 2. Okay, let's verify. If it's negative 2, let's see, negative 2, ito, tama-tama, di ba? It's almost zero. Okay, pag tumaas mo lang tumaas yan, magiging zero na siya. It approaches zero. Okay? Next, the cumulative area increases as the scores increase. So, you will notice then, di ba? The cumulative area, pagpataas ng pataas, spaghetti pataas, di ba? Tumataas din na cumulative area. Ayan din na yun. 1.00, 1.001, 1.01 rather, negative 1.02, negative 1.03, tumataas siya. So on and so forth. Okay? Then, the cumulative area for Z is equal to 0 is 0.50. Let's double check. So, you know, 0.50. Tama tayo, di ba? Because Z is equal to 0 is the mean. Okay? Bakit siya 50%? Because we have talked about in the previous video but that the area of, the total area of a normal distribution is 100% or 1.00. And they are symmetric with each other. So, tig 50% sila. Diba? Yeah, tig 0.50 sila. And the commutative area is close to 1 for Z scores close to 3.49. Tignan natin ulit. If the area is close to 3.49, ito na sa dulo na yun. O, 0.99998. Okay? Kulang na lang ng 0.0002. Okay? Para maging 100 or 1.00. Okay? Now, so as I mentioned to you a while ago, the one that we are doing in finding the area under the standard normal distribution is the left method. Okay? So the left of the z-score method. But there are also cases to which we need to find the area to the right of the standard normal distribution. Or to the left, or in between two values, or two z-scores. It's either nasa, yung isa nasa right side ng mean, yung isa nasa left side ng mean, okay? Or it's either yung dalawang z-score ay nasa left side ng mean, or yung isang z-score ay nasa, dalawang z-score ay nasa right side ng mean. Pwede rin yung mean at saka nasa right side ng z-score, then mean saka nasa left side ng mean rather ganun z-score niya. So pwede yun. How do we find the values or the area under it? There are guidelines to follow. First is we are to find the area to the left of Z, find the area that corresponds to in the normal distribution table or the Z table. Gawa natin yan kanina. And then if we are to find the area to the right of Z, we use the standard normal distribution table to find the area that corresponds to Z. Then subtract the area from 1. Take note ha, we subtract the area from 1. First, yung left side method. Muna kukunin natin. And then, pag nakukuha natin yung area using the left side method, we subtract it from 1. Meaning that 1 is our subtrahend. Okay? And for the third case, to which we are to find the area between two scores, find the area corresponding to each z-score in the normal distribution table, then subtract the smaller from the larger area. Okay, for us to better understand it, let's have an example. So, solution for number 3. So, we are to find the area to the left of Z. The area to the left of Z. So, Z. Ito ngayon, 1.54 yung sinasabi ko sa inyo. Okay? So, is gagamit tayo dyan ngayon ng Z table. 1.54. Ito ngayon. 0.9382 or this is 93.82%. Okay, letter B, area, okay, to the right of Z is equal to negative 0.95. Z to the right now. Okay? -0.95. Sabi dito, we need to find first the area, okay, to the left muna of -0.95. So that's C. Ito muna. Kunin niyo muna 'yan, ha. Ito muna. Then we subtract it by 1. From 1 rather. Okay? Ulitin ko, ha. Pag to the right kasi nasa right side 'yun, eh. Kunin mo natin yung area to the left, then subtract it by 1. Bakit 1, sir? Diba? Again, the total area is 1.00 or 100%. So, this becomes 1 minus, then we need to find the area, -0.95. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 0.1711. 0.1711. Then using our calculators, 1 minus 0.1711 is, this is 0.8289, or this is 82.89%. Okay, and for letter C, area of Z, which is in between -1.96 and +1.96. So, anong first task daw natin dyan? First, kunin muna natin yung area, okay, to the left of Z, 1.96. And the area to the left of Z of -1.96, kunin muna natin sila. Okay? Sabi sa atin kanina. So, the area of -1.96, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0.0250. Okay? And the area for Z to the left of 1.96 is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 0.9750. Okay? Then sabi doon, we need to subtract the smaller from the larger. Okay? So, smaller from the larger. So, this is 0.9750 minus 0.0250 is 0.95. Okay? 0.95%. Notice, tinan nyo. Notice that ito yung empirical rule natin. Diba? Two standard deviations away from the mean. From the mean is 95% of the data. Well, 1.96 and -1.96 is almost 2. Okay? So, therefore, the empirical rule, which is a rule of thumb, does not lie. Okay? It's correct. Okay? Okay. Ito na. Find the area under the normal curve given that, ito, madali na lang ito. Ito, meron tayong given example kanina. So, balikan na lang natin. Oh, 1.50. So the area of it is 1.50 is, let's see. Basahin niyo lang naman 'yan doon. Ito, 0.9332. Okay? And the area of this one, okay, -1.17. Ayan, kaya nyo na to. -1.17 okay, 0.1234567 0.1210 0.1210. Okay, that is how you use the cumulative or the Z table to find the area or the cumulative area of a Z score. Okay, now ito, let's have a story. So during the chapter test in statistics and probability, Hosea got a score of 48 out of 55. The mean score of the class is 40 with a standard deviation of 4. Okay, assuming that the scores are normally distributed, tanong dyan, find the standard score that corresponds to Hosea's test score. Ito, kayang-kaya nyo na ito. For letter A, number 4. For letter A, we need to find first our mean. Our mean, ano nga yung mean natin kanina? Is 40. Our standard deviation is 4. Then our x is 48. Then we need to convert it into z score. Okay? So z is 48 minus 40 all over 4. This one is 8 all over 4 is 2.00. Okay? That's it. So the Z score that corresponds to Hosea's normal score or raw, lagyan natin pareho lang yan, raw score of 48 is 2.00. Okay, now next, letter B, how many of her classmates did Hosea surpass if they are 32 students in class? If they are all in all 32, how many of the classmates did she surpass? Okay, so what are we going to do? First, we need to find the area that corresponds to the left of z-score, which is 2.00. Okay, so using the z-table, 2.00, nasan ba yung 2.00 dyan? Ayun, 0.9773, and we will multiply this by the number of students, 32 students. Okay, so approximately ilan ang tinalo ni Hosea? So 0.9773 times 32 students is approximately 31 students. Okay, that's it. Next, for letter C, what can you say about Hosea's performance in her chapter tests? So, upon looking at the result, okay, since there are 32 students and 31 ang tinalo niya, we can say that Hosea's test score or normal score is the highest score. Okay? Next, last. Okay. Determine. Hosea yan, ha? Hindi lang na-edit. It's Hosea. Determine Hosea's score. Sorry. Determine, papalitan ko to. Determine Merry Christmas score. Okay? Hosea's classmate. Okay? Raw score, assuming that she took the same test, given that his Z-score is 1.24. Okay? Negative 1.24. Ito pala na-edit. Sorry. So, but before that, let's determine first. So, given yung Z, which is negative 1.24, yung mean natin kanina given then, which is 40, and our standard deviation is 4. This time, what is unknown is the raw score or the normal score. Okay, so how do we do it? First, let's have our formula. Z is equal to X minus the mean over SD. Okay, so what are we to do? To separate all the variables here, and what should be left is the variable X. Okay, we need to derive a formula in such a way that we can convert the normal score to the Z score. Ito kanina. We can convert the normal score to Z score, or Z score to normal score. Ito kasi normal. From normal score to Z-score. Okay? But what we are looking is baliktad. From Z-score naman, babalik na rin natin. From Z-score to normal score. Wala pa tayong alam dyan. Okay? So what are we going to do? So, using the formula, Z is equal to X minus mu over SD. What can I do is to multiply both sides of the equation by sigma, okay? In which I can cancel out sigma because that's 1 already, and I can multiply sigma times Z is Z times sigma. So kahit sinong saan ang mauna, okay lang, because that's commutative property of multiplication. And then what remain is X minus the mu. So what we can do also is to add both sides by u or mu, which is additive inverse. So Z times sigma plus mu, where the mean is equal to X minus mu plus mu. So we can cancel this one because it's zero. That's the additive inverse. And we are able to come up with X is equal to Z times sigma plus mu. Okay? So, sir, bakit naging nasa left side na si X, nasa right side sa kanina? Okay lang yan, because that's symmetric property of equality. Sir, pwede magbaliktad si mean? Itong dalawang to, pwede magbaliktad? Pwede pa rin. That's commutative property of addition. Okay? Okay lang yun. Itong dalawa, pwede magbaliktad? Okay pa lang din. Pero itong dalawa, pwede magbaliktad? Hindi. Yan na yan. Okay? So we are able to come up with a formula on how to convert Z score, okay, to normal score. Okay? So using that formula, X is equal to Z times SD plus the mean. Just plug in the given values. Our Z is negative 1.24 times 4 plus 40. I have here negative 1.24. 1.24 times 4 is negative 4.96 plus 40, okay, is 35.04. Okay? Or it's approximately 35 because we are talking about the normal score now. So therefore, we can say that Merry Christmas lalagay ko, ha? Oh, Merry Christmas kasi hindi lang na-edit. Merry Christmas. numeric, therefore, bakit may dot niya? Okay. Therefore, numeric basis, normal score, okay, that corresponds to her z-score of negative 1.24 is 30. So let's go back to all the things that we discussed in this topic. We learned that a standard normal random variable is a normal random variable whose mean is 0 and whose standard deviation is 1. We also learned that there is only one standard normal distribution. We also learned that we can convert a normal random variable to its corresponding standard normal variable using the formula Z is equal to X minus the mean over sigma. We have discussed that we can convert a standard normal variable to its corresponding normal random variable using the derived formula X is equal to Z times sigma plus the mean. And finally, we learned that the standard normal distribution table or the Z table is used to find the area under the standard normal. Okay, before I end up my video, I would like to leave something to ponder from Steve Maraboli, who said that the most powerful relationship you will ever have is the relationship with yourself. It is in this relationship that you set the standard for all others. Ang sinasabi lang ni Steve Maraboli that if you don't respect yourself, if you don't love yourself, don't expect that others will love you or respect you as well, because loving yourself and respecting yourself is the standard you are setting towards others. Okay, these are my references, and thank you so much for listening, and God bless you.